Thanks, trendsetters. Welcome to Stetina's Paydirt. It's time to check out some of the bikes here. Look at this bike. We've got a Canyon Grizl with front suspension, the Rockshox Rudy.
Comes with a beer in it.
Comes with beer as well, yes. And of course, a SRAM Force E-Tap Access, one by likely a Explore drivetrain. Good luck tomorrow, mate. Next up, Sage Titanium with a hybrid drivetrain. Force E-Tap shifters. Rival one by on the derailleur and crank and tie frame. It's really interesting squid compared with some Paul's components. Look at that livery, it's fantastic, isn't it?
Latest work coming out of Rancho Cordova.
And it's running a mechanical SRAM setup. One by with a very small cassette. But a small chainring. I wish you luck. Niner, RLT9 RDO. It's a steel bike. The drivetrain is a mismatch of components. SRAM Rival Mechanical. Hunt wheel set, and notice all of the cables are run externally. Ease of maintenance. Rival rear derailleur with a third-party cassette. Specialized, looks like a Crux, I might have got that wrong. Zip 303S wheels, I have reviewed those. Check those out, linked in the description below. Force one by drivetrain with the power meter. And shod with Pirelli Cinturato tires. Very no-nonsense setup, E-tap, and notice how the shifters are angled in. No flare on the handlebar, but let's look at those shifters from another angle. They are severely angled in, whatever works for you. Now we have a wide open fitted out with SRAM Force E-tap access. And we've got a mullet build happening here. It's an Eagle rear derailleur. Look at that cassette. Bloody huge. Obviously set up for climbing. Very, very bright canyon here. It's very hard to miss this canyon. It's very well coordinated with this handlebar bag on the front. I think this is the Grinduro edition of the Grizl. Rigid fork, no suspension. 2x, GRX 11 speed. Nice tight cassette ratio. RC Boken, double cross tires, tubeless of course. Nice setup. Habanero titanium coupler bike. Cross bike no less. Rim brakes, beautiful. Could be the only rim brake bike here today. And a 2x, excellent setup. A sweet Haley, beautiful frame. I have a video link below, you can check this sort of bike out in more detail. Nice. And titanium, of course.
Custom.
Custom, no less. There's the owner.
All custom.
And we have an ENVE Mog here.
It's got 2.1 tires on it.
With massive 2.1 tires. This dude is set up ready to go. And it's got a mullet build.
Yeah, by the great truck right there.
Look at those monster tires, will you?
For the big tires.
Schwalbe Thunderbirds.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't intend to run them in there.
Folks, we've got a giant Revolt X. I didn't say revolting, I said Revolt X. And it's got the suspension fork, the Rockshox Rudy. Excellent fork, that is. The gentleman who owns this bike is pretty smart, because there could be some dodgy descents today. It's a mullet build, SRAM Force. MTB rear derailleur, E-tap of course, and Maxxis Rambler tires. Oh yes, 700C by 45. Another detail, it also has a dropper seat post triggered from this lever, right there, left side of the handlebars. Very cool bike right here. State Bicycle Company with the SBC, State Bicycle Company fork, flat bar configuration, no less. Love the colorway on this bike. Sendero tires by WTB, and they are 650B. Here we have an Argon 18. You don't see many of these. Interesting bike. They've got the curved fork up front, and this is another SRAM build, but it's a 2x. Force build. Love 2x. Much tighter cassette ratio. ENVE AG25 foundation wheels. Pathfinder Pro tires. They are 45s?
47s.
47s.
Going big.
I don't blame you, mate. Going big is the way to go.
We're
here
too
today.
Small last
year. 38s were not big enough last year. This is a Spot, which is a brand out of Colorado, I understand. Look at that chainstay. It's on the other side. I'll show it to you momentarily, but it's got a drop seat post. Really interesting bike. I haven't seen an elevated chainstay like that in a long time.
It never happened to my bike.
And of course, the wireless dropper seat post is fantastic. Really cool setup. Wheel set is the ENVE G23, a wheel set I have reviewed. Fantastic stuff. And he's not mucking around here. This is SRAM Red Explorer Access. Life too short. Really sweet rock lobster. You don't see many of those. One by Shimano drivetrain. Beautiful. Another cross bite. This is the second one I've spotted so far. It's a Trek Cronus. Look at the tilting in of the brake levers there. That's interesting. And the crazy sparkly handlebar tape. Rim brakes. And mind you, they're the best. Average shorty ultimates.
Really?
Really wet.
One bike configuration. SRAM GX rear derailleur. These are pretty narrow tires. Boken double cross. What are they, 30s?
Yes.
Mate, you're a crazy guy. Good luck today.
Thank you.
Behold, a Storck, a German brand. You don't see many of these. This is the Platinum model. Well, maybe it's the Grix too. Anyway.
It's both.
It's both. With a Force E-Tap 1x build, Explorer cassette in the back, obviously matching rear derailleur, DT Swiss carbon wheels. Nice setup. And right alongside it, we've got a very purple Otso. And I've shot a video of this particular bike and did a review on the bike and also a factory tour of Wolftail HQ up in Minnesota. Waheela C, a really nice bike. And once again, a mullet build. Look at that cassette. Climbs the walls in that bloody thing. Very nice. Rodeo Labs, whatever you want to call it. Now, this is not the original funky paint job that I spotted at the Philadelphia Bike Expo, but it's a close match. Another mullet build here. Very popular around this neck of the woods. As are SRAM drivetrains. Mosaic out of, I think, near Boulder, Colorado. Anyway, I have done a factory tour with these guys, and this Mosaic is fitted out with Campagnolo's Eckar drivetrain. The first campy bike I've spotted today. Love that group set. I have a review linked in the description below. Behold, an Evil Chamois Hagar. This is a bike I reviewed a couple of years ago. It is possibly the best downhill machine. It is very, very interesting. Crazy angles. GRX 1x build, mechanical, no less. WTB Venture tires in 700C by 50mm. Wider is better at Pete Stetina's Paydirt. Additionally, the dropper seat post, which makes this bike really special because you can get really, really low, and it's all about control and such when you're descending. So there you have it, trendsetters, another fascinating video. And if you're curious about how I fared at the 2024 Stetina's Paydirt, that video is linked below and the little box on screen. Additionally, links to the bike I rode, the beautiful Framework Bicycles custom gravel bike, shod with none other than Shimano's latest GRX DI2 12-speed semi-wireless drivetrain. Details about that drivetrain also linked below, etc. As always, thank you for watching. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing to the Gravel Cyclist YouTube channel for interesting content such as this. No bullshit. Gravel bike reviews, other product reviews. What else? Ride experience videos. Ah, yes. and general madness. Yeah, about 3 pounds lighter, nice. As all of it is released to the channel. Well, now it's time to go to my regular job. I'll see you in the next video.